This video is about creating a cheat sheet. So cheat sheets are fun, they're all over the internet, and you can find them on just about any tool or language or framework. I like cheat sheets because they're a really great way to reinforce my learning. They're also a really great way to build new knowledge. I also recommend building a cheat sheet as a way to expand your portfolio. That's advice that I often give to current and aspiring data scientists and data professionals. I say, if you're looking to expand your portfolio, create a cheat sheet. My name is Adam Ross Nelson, and I'm a data scientist. Overall, this channel is for folks who are looking to enter or level up in the data field. I really hope this video on cheat sheets will be useful to you. The first step in creating a cheat sheet is to roughly sketch out the areas of the cheat sheet that you want to use, sort of make for yourself a template. So I already have an idea what I want on my cheat sheet. My cheat sheet is going to be a crosswalk, a Rosetta Stone between Stata language and Python language. I'm going to do my work in Procreate. Procreate is a drawing program that you can get for iPad. It's a popular one. There are a lot of instructional videos about Procreate on YouTube. And I'm not here to give a tutorial on Procreate, but I am here to say that Procreate would be a great tool for this, but there are lots of other tools that you can use as well. One of the features that I like for this tool, and actually that I like for all of the tools, is that you can set up a series of layers. So you can put on, you can basically stack these layers in your photo editor so that you can have examples that you will, from which you will draw inspiration. So on the lower levels, I will have other cheat sheets that I have found available online. And then eventually what I'm going to do is I'm going to be able to toggle those levels on and off so I can see through the stack of layers. And then I can also pick the features and the formats that I like the most from various choices. Another thing I can do is I can put a layer on top of all of the cheat sheets that will mimic tracing paper. So I can trace over the template. Here I'm creating the tracing paper layer. And basically what I'll do is I'll create a white background for this tracing paper layer. And I will reduce the transparency, or increase the transparency, actually. So as I manipulate the transparency here, you can see how you get to see the underlying inspirational cheat sheets. And then on top of my tracing paper layer, I'm going to create my actual drawing layer. This is the layer that I'll actually be working in. So one of the things I notice about most cheat sheets is that on the upper left, there is like a title box, I'll call it. There's a box that tells you what the cheat sheet is about, gives you a little bit of context, background information, probably identifies the author. So I'm sketching out in blue pencil this title box. And then in the title box, I'm going to go ahead and write in my title. I know that it's the Stata Python Rosetta Stone. I'm also going to go ahead and sketch out my subtitle here. I can use the drawing program to zoom in and get a little finer drawing point on that. The subtitle is going to be side-by-side crosswalk. Now that I have the title box looking pretty much the way I want it, I have this, I intentionally sort of saved the entire height, the entire length of the far right margin here. And I'm going to use that space to create an additional notes section or some additional narrative. I'm going to be able to put a lot of information there that's going to talk a little bit about some of the conventions that the two different languages use. The theory here is that someone who's interested in a Rosetta Stone crosswalking Python to Stata or Stata to Python is they'll be familiar in one language with the various conventions that are popular in Stata, but they won't necessarily be familiar with the conventions that are in Python. So I can write a lot about some of that contextual information here on this sidebar, this margin area. So here I am sketching that in. I'm borrowing from the other cheat sheets. All the other cheat sheets sort of have the title areas, this dark bold area, and then they have white text on top of that. So I've created that white area, or I'm sorry, I've created that that dark area across the top, and that's where I'll put my title. I'll explain what's going on in this marginal area, and then I'll have a box around there as well. I might even shade in that box before I'm done, before I have a finished product. Now I'll change my pencil and I'll change my tips a little bit. And one of the things I've noticed that this cheat sheet did is it put its topics over on the right-hand side. And I want to do the same thing, and it put it on the right-hand side and then twisted the text 90 degrees. I want to do the same thing, but I'm going to actually move that over to the left. I'm going to put my topics on the left, and then the information is going to be to the right for each of my main topics. So here I am back at my tracing paper selection, and I'm going to pick my bold, dark background that I can put text on top of, and then I'm going to create those topic bars. Of course, I should be consistent about the colors. That's one of the things I would recommend if you're making a cheat sheet. If you're making one cheat sheet, you'll probably make a few cheat sheets. So do yourself a favor and pick a color that you like. Pick a very limited color palette, just two or maybe three colors, and stick to those three colors across all of your cheat sheets. Another tip you can do is pick a font that you like, or pick a couple fonts that you like, and stick to those fonts across all of your cheat sheets. So here I've drawn in my topic areas, and I think I want to make a slight adjustment to this top one. I'm going to erase that a little bit to create a little bit more margin in order to play with. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to have two main columns through this section here. I'm replicating that from the inspiration, as you can see below. There's sort of two main columns. And in my two main columns, I'm going to have one column for my Stata code and one column for my Python code. And then I'm going to put task level topics across the rows. And here I am sort of drawing in dividers to help delineate each of the topics from each other. As you're working through this, you can add text, you can add lines. And just remember, this doesn't have to be perfect. Remember, nobody else is going to see this. The only reason you're seeing it is because I'm making this demonstration video. But most people aren't going to have a chance to see how you sketch out this cheat sheet, except for yourself. I recommend saving it with saving whatever sketch you make for yourself next to your final product, so you can remember how and why you made some of the decisions that you might have made in the final product. Here I am drawing what will probably be code. I'm going to put the code here. So the idea is the code on the left will accomplish a task, we'll say task or topic A, and then the code in Stata, and then the code on the right will accomplish topic A in Python. Back to what I was saying a moment ago is you don't have to be perfect with this. You're just making for yourself a template. You're giving yourself a rough sketch of what your cheat sheet is going to look like. And it really does help to spend some time on this. You can also just do it on plain paper, pen and paper. I'm doing it here on the iPad in order to make it easier to share in a video. And I think, in fact, the first time I did this, I roughed it out on a whiteboard. So that's another opportunity. Get a whiteboard up or some flip chart paper up, and you can sketch out what your cheat sheet is going to look like, what major sections it'll have, and how it'll be organized. The last thing I do is I take away all of the transparency from my tracing paper layer, and then I can zoom out and manipulate and show myself, or for you on this video, I can show what the final result looks like. And there it is. That's the end of the first step. So now the next step is going to be able to take this over to PowerPoint. So I'll switch screens and we'll see you at the PowerPoint step. So here we are at pretty much a blank PowerPoint slide. And what I'm going to show you is mostly a time-lapsed version of me building this cheat sheet. So you can see that I've already got my title box in, and I've also got that contextual sidebar in here as well. Actually, let me zoom in a little bit, and here you can see that I have to do some gaming of the graphics in order to get it to look, get the effect that I want it to have just right. So each graphic element needs to be in the right order, back, middle, front, and then I also need to adjust the roundedness of this corner a little bit. I also had to use two boxes, so I used one box with rounded four corners, and then I used another box with just four square corners in order to create this half rounded effect. Zooming back out, here I am adding my topical areas that are vertical text that are on the left. And then now I'm already adding in the code that goes across the rows. And then where you have the columns, where you have one column for Stata, one column for Python. Now I'll work a little bit on the title box. Title box in the upper left has a lot of contextual and background information. And the last thing is to look at the attribution. So I think it's smart to make sure that your name is emblazoned in prominent ways on the cheat sheets that you make, especially as you distribute them. You want credit for that work. And then I also recommend putting some sort of license on your work. Here, I'm using the Creative Commons license framework. If you Google Creative Commons, and if you don't know about Creative Commons, do yourself a favor and find out about Creative Commons and learn how to use that in order to mark your work. And then also in order to help guarantee that you get attribution for your work in the future, and that you can also make sure you give proper attribution to the work that other people are doing. So there it is. That's the basic two-step process for creating a cheat sheet. And I know I didn't go into a lot of detail there in PowerPoint. I didn't want this to be a PowerPoint tutorial. I didn't want this to be a Procreate tutorial. I wanted this to be inspiration and a tutorial on how to create a cheat sheet for yourself. Once again, cheat sheets are a really great way to reinforce your learning. They're also a really great way to achieve new learning, learn new topics for yourself. And they're a great way to expand or enhance your portfolio. And if you're looking to get your portfolio started, this is also a really great way to go. So I hope you're learning a lot. I hope you had a little bit of fun. And I look forward to seeing you in another video. Don't forget, you're more ready than you think you are. Hit subscribe, check out these other videos, and let's connect. I look forward to being in touch.